Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Anna and today I want to show how I made this awesome spinach and cheesecake, or spanakopita as you know it. Super easy and delicious. I'm gonna need frozen spinach, and I have here a bag of 450 grams and I let it defrost, and I'm gonna squeeze out the excess water out of it. Also, I'm gonna need feta cheese, or 300 grams of these, or cow cheese, a salty one, so feta or this cheese, 2 cloves of garlic, 1 onion, 4 eggs, parsley and dill, fresh ones, and also I'm gonna add some spring onion and spring garlic, a pack of 400 grams of phyllo pastry, a frozen one, but you can use fresh, olive oil of course, and some freshly ground pepper. If you want to add some butter, you can do it. I'm gonna use just olive oil. As I said, the spinach that I bought, it is frozen, so I let it defrost, and either you squeeze it within your palms in order to get rid of that excess water, or put it in a strainer. Break the cheese in smaller pieces, crumble it like this. It's delicious. I really like this cheese pie. Over all of these, add eggs. All 4 of them. Mix everything together. You can chop onion really fine, but I used this food processor to grind onion, garlic, parsley and dill. I just chop it up in bigger pieces in order for them to fit in that food processor, and put all of these greenery over spinach, cheese and eggs. Mix everything together. As I said, I had in my fridge some spring onion and spring garlic. We use here quite a lot of spring garlic, so I chopped a few of those. Add pepper as you taste. I didn't add any more salt. Cheese has enough salt, so I didn't add any more salt. And also the phyllo pastry have some salt as well, so don't add more salt. Here, that spring onion and garlic that I told you, also use food processor to make them smaller, and add them in our cheese, egg and spinach mixture. It's gonna be super fresh, this pie, and delicious, full of vitamins and color. Phyllo pastry, I told you that I bought them frozen, so I let them come to room temperature, maneuver them with lots of care, because they are super tender, and if you let them dry at the air too much, they will break apart. So either you keep a moist towel and cover them while you work with them, or you just cover them with that plastic film that they came with. In the dish that I'm gonna bake this pie, I'm gonna drizzle some olive oil and place a phyllo pastry on top of that. As you can see, phyllo pastry is bigger than my dish in which I'm gonna bake the pie, but I'm gonna overlap that excess phyllo pastry, that excess sheet of dough. Grease each phyllo pastry at a time as you put them in your dish. I use about 3/4 of that pack because I had in the pack about 15 of these sheets of dough, so they were quite a lot for my dish. So I use about 3/4 of the pack. Just place them in your dish, one on top of each other. Carefully, not to break them apart, grease them and let that excess dough outside of the dish. Make sure to turn your oven on. You need to preheat it at 175 Celsius or 347 Fahrenheit. Put the filling inside your dish and level it nicely with a spoon, and now cover it with that excess phyllo dough that we left on the outside of your dish. Also grease each of those phyllo pastry and overlap them. So start with one side, cover again with the other side, and so on. You can use some melted butter also if you like. I use only olive oil this time. After you cover all your spinach with those phyllo pastry, just cut them in serving portions, but don't cut all the way through with a knife, and put the dish in the oven for about 30-35 minutes until the stuffing will be nice and thick, and also the phyllo pastry will be super crisp and yummy. The pie looks delicious. Leave it to cool down at least 30 minutes after you took it out from the oven. Smells incredibly, and I serve it with some Greek salad as well. Easy to prepare, healthy and delicious. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, find reasons to smile, and I'll see you here next time with another recipe. Bye bye.